Your radar above-head right now is still showing some action, whereas we were anticipating at least a little more clearing than we've seen. We still have rain here in the valleys, and we're consistently still seeing snow and some of those higher elevations. Now, that snow is favoring the northern and central mountains this morning, and a advisory from the National Weather Service does still remain in effect for some areas. But overall, we're really looking at a freeze watch this morning, and that has still stuck with us. Now, with that sticking with us, it's actually expanded. Yesterday it was only for the Delta, Montrose, and Hotchkiss areas, but now it's for a much wider range. You're expecting the Grand Junction area along with Fruta, Loma, and Mac, Palisade, and Parachute, and then even looking at Nucla, experiencing sub-freezing temperatures. Now, sub-freezing temperatures are roughly around 27 or 28 degrees. And why is this a big deal? This is a pretty big deal because we are going to see agricultural damage. Now, that could cause a harsh freeze that ends the agricultural season for many individuals. And of course, that could be a big financial decision for many. So we take that into heavy consideration here in Western Colorado, as we acknowledge we have a large agricultural industry. So keep an eye on that this afternoon and evening, especially as we approach the evening hours. You'll see some of that change. But for the majority of the day today, if you're trying to plan your day, you're not really expecting much. You're going to warm up, but only slightly. We're in the 30s this morning trying to warm up, and you're only getting to about 42 to 49 degrees by the end of the day. Lunchtime, only 42 degrees. So that means if you're sending kiddos to school, they have an outdoor recess, an outdoor lunch period, it still is not that warm. You're definitely going to want to bundle up on the way out the house this morning, and you're going to continue to see colder temperatures and maybe even the residual rainfall for a few hours this morning. That includes 10 and 11 a.m. and right now it's only about 6:30, so we are going to consistently see some changes in what we're consistently calling the storm system that is still with us here in Western Colorado, and we do expect it to move up and out of our way. But the next time you could see moisture, that's actually not too far away, but fortunately it's not on Halloween. So today we still finish up with that moisture. We have some pretty cold temperatures overnight tonight, but then moving into your next 5 days. Your next 5 days, you're expecting to see rain return to Western Colorado. That's bringing you a 20% chance for moisture on your Sunday and into your Monday. And now with that being said, that means that we could actually see more snow by this point as well. But Thursday is dry, and Thursday is Halloween. So I know Halloween and trick-or-treating is on a lot of people's minds this morning, and that's just as we anticipate the day ahead. And tomorrow evening, if you want an hour-by-hour breakdown for what you can expect if you're taking young ones trick-or-treating, it's going to be about 53 degrees, which is not warm by 6 p.m., 7 p.m., 49, and then by 8, only 46 degrees. And we're going to consistently stay on the colder side today, and we're going to consistently also see some warm temperatures. Now, the warmer temperatures are, of course, going to be at least in the Grand Junction area comparatively to yesterday, but overall, they're really not that much warmer. And you are seeing those really chilly lows like we talked about overnight last night. And briefly talking about what you're going to see on those 7-day forecasts, Grand Junction, I mentioned, for Halloween is going to be dry, but it's not going to be warm. At least we lose a little bit of that cloud coverage by tomorrow. And then moving into the rest of the week, you're going to consistently see some changes when it comes to Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. That's when we're going to see our temperatures changing to from the 60s and back to the 50s for some rain. We're going to see Montrose with some rain again today, and they're going to see a little bit of moisture on Saturday and Sunday, a 20% chance on moving forward with that cloud coverage increasing. But Halloween is dry in Delta. We're looking at 54 degrees in the Delta area tomorrow. Today, only 49, and then Cortez, only 47 today, with Thursday, 55 degrees.